Hi all. If you've been up to date with my videos, you know that I and another YouTube subscriber and friend have been helping a woman who had been going under an attack. And she has graciously agreed to write her story, which is a lot more involved than what I first started hearing from her. And I have others who have come to me in the last year telling me things that they've been going through. And if you watch this video and you do not want to expose yourself to the public, but you want your story out there, all I say is either use your YouTube channel or your name, whichever, or both. In Jackie's case, she would prefer just her name being used and not her channel. So I'm going to read to you now what I just got from her today as an email, okay? It says, Charlene has asked me to share some of my story. She has helped me greatly to deal with what is happening to me, and I am now receiving help and healing from many sources here and out there in the spirit world. I am so grateful to her and her guides that I wanted to help them and in return, help them in return. Maybe my story can help someone else. I would like to thank God and everyone, you know who you are, who has helped me, supported me, answered my questions, comforted me, and prayed for me. I am very grateful. I believe I have been spiritually under attack for about 40 years by three malignant entities. This has been confirmed for me by Charlene and her guides. About the age of three, I started to beat my head against the wall to stop the voices. This my mom confirmed for me. I was about 6 years old. As a child, I was so abused by these voices that this abuse continued out into the world. It was like I had a sign on my back that said, "Kick me." These beings dehumanized me, filled me with such despair and loathing. I really felt I had deserved the abuse I received. I just accepted it. Never once did I question, "Hey, what did I do to deserve that?" I became introverted, shy. I had a speech impediment. I would refuse to leave the house and I stopped speaking. I suffered terribly from panic attacks and I still do. I spent most of my time alone and I had no friends. Everyone thought I was very strange. I feel that they could sense what was in me and I scared them away. I believe they want me to feel isolated. I suffered from incapacitating headaches. I suffered from pain all over my body most of my life. Scans and medical tests have proven nothing yet. I am still in constant pain. I was told the pain was because I was depressed and I was prescribed antidepressant medication or antidepressants. Medication just lowered my resistance to psychic attacks even more, and I became suicidal. I have tried to commit suicide many times through my life, the worst of it when I was a teenager. I have been homeless, raped, used and thrown out like garbage, and passively accepted it all because I believed I deserved it. I truly believed that I was told God didn't love me. He didn't care what happened to someone like me. I have found myself on ledges about to jump, stepping into traffic. I have felt the urge to drive my car off the road into a tree at full speed. I have wanted to gas myself, hang myself, overdose on drugs, and have slit my wrist. I have put myself in dangerous situations where I have been attacked by others and could have lost my life. I don't know how I got there. I don't know what I was thinking. I knew it wasn't me. I didn't want to die, but the voices were strong, very strong. 5 years ago, my husband had to wrestle a carving knife from my hands because I had been brought so low by the voices I was trying to slit my wrists. I just kept saying to him, "You would all be better off without me," begging him to let me die. I have never felt such despair, but I have not tried to kill myself since. I went cold turkey on the antidepressants. That was hell. I still get the urge to give up, the visions on how to kill myself, the despair. But I don't attempt to kill myself anymore. Since I stopped taking the medication, I feel stronger. I have always known deep in my heart that I was under attack. I kept silent, especially when my children came along. The voices told me that if I spoke of them, if I tried to get help, I would lose my children. They would be taken away from me, and they would die horrible deaths at the hands of evil men. I was shown visions so real of them dying, I would wake up screaming, shaking, thinking they were already dead. I would run to their rooms expecting to find them gone. It was terrifying and very real. These images are burnt into my head. They still haunt me. I don't sleep very well and get up to at least 4 to 5 times a night to check on them. My voices have told me if I killed myself that my children would live happier lives without me. My husband deserves a better woman than me. If I died, my children would be safe. They even made me agree to kill myself to keep them safe, my life for theirs. Always the voices have told me I am useless, a waste of space. I have achieved nothing. I am a bad mother, wife, daughter, friend, and I have nothing to live for anymore. They have brought me so low that I can't trust my own inner voice because I don't know if it's me or them speaking. They have stopped me from spiritual learning. It is like I have a wall, a darkness over my third eye, and whenever I attempt to learn, the pressure builds, the pain grows. I become ill and the sensation only stops when I give up. When I try to meditate, I am brought back gasping for breath and my heart racing with the sensation of being choked. This is forbidden. I am not allowed to talk to the spiritual realm. I have felt alone all my life. I have felt cut off. I don't feel the love of my guides. I don't feel the love of God or Jesus. I don't even know if they can hear me when I pray to them. I can't hear them. Despite this, I have never lost my faith and pray every night for the protection of my family and myself. All I feel is emptiness, like no one is listening. I feel abandoned, confused, unloved, unworthy. Whenever I turn to spiritual people for help, my emotions run to hate, anger, and I can smell burning rubber. I am forced away from these people. I turn my back on them and walk away. I feel emotions that they are evil, that they will harm me and don't need them, and I don't need them. I know that this isn't me. These emotions are not me. It is their own fear I can feel. I can feel this negative entity weighing down on me like a bully forcing me to walk away. I can feel its overwhelming anger come spilling all over me, hating me, scaring me, pushing me away from knowledge and enlightenment. One time my husband, after a particularly bad time I was having, did a hands-on healing with 2 spiritual friends of ours. They laid their hands on me and prayed for healing. My husband was attacked. He saw a demon with wings leave my body and push into him, forcing him back on the lounge. He could feel the evil emanating off this being, but he would not be moved. His guides came in to protect him, and he stood his ground, kept praying. He said later it scared the hell out of him, but he wasn't going to be bullied like that. My husband is my strength. He has never doubted me. He has stood by me through all this craziness, and he believes me. Many times he could have taken the kids and left me. What has happened to me is very, very real, and he believes me. I know I'm not mad. He knows I'm not mad. He sees who I really am, and he loves me. I want you all to know that all my life, deep down, I have known that there has been a malignant presence around me. I am very aware of it. I know it wasn't me. I knew it wasn't God. But it totally overwhelmed me with emotions that weren't mine. But what it hasn't done is defeat me. What it has done is made me stronger, made me a fighter. I didn't give up, you see, because I am still here. I am still alive. I am glad of this experience. It has made me a better person. I truly hope sharing some of my experience will help others. Thanks, Jackie. I hope it does too. Bless you.